I've just been chatting to a friend of mine who is about to tackle their first ever non-wetsuit swim here in Kona. And it's reminded me of some of the challenges and the fears that come with having to ditch the wetsuit ahead of an open water swim. And well, it's inspired me to revisit the topic and answer their questions in the hope of also helping you guys ahead of your next open water non-wetsuit swim. There is an element of comfort that comes with wearing a wetsuit. And if you've ever been near a swim start where the temperature is on the cusp of being too warm, and then the announcers make that dreaded announcement that it is going to be a non-wetsuit swim, you will have sensed and felt that slight panic that ripples through a lot of the triathletes as they start to get their heads around the fact that they are going to have to go without their wetsuit. Well, we're here to prevent that feeling and make sure that you are prepared if that happens to you. So I have got 7 points that you need to consider. And this is a really natural and a really common fear because the wetsuit is designed to help you be more buoyant. That's why we all find swimming in a wetsuit easier. And also, it's not just the all-over buoyancy, it's the fact that they will have patches that will maybe help your legs float more than your arms, for example, and the different thicknesses. So it is going to feel a little bit different. However, if you do most of your training open water in a freshwater lake or river, then if your race is in the sea, you will naturally get an all-over body buoyancy, even if you're ditching your wetsuit. So that will help a little bit. But then you need to really make sure that you are practicing doing some swimming without a wetsuit and also without aid. So if it happens to be somewhere warm enough for open water, great. But like most of us, you'll probably have to be limited to a swimming pool. And it's fine to use aids for some of your training, but make sure that you don't rely on neoprene shorts or a pool boy, because when you get to the open water swimming without a wetsuit, you're not gonna have that buoyancy. So you need to really focus on your body position. So make sure you work a lot on your head position in the water, which will help hopefully keep your body more horizontal. And even if you are a tiny bit lower when it comes to swimming in the water without a wetsuit, you'll still have the correct feel. This is probably not a factor in Kona, but if you're swimming somewhere where the temperature was just on the cusp of being warm enough in the water and the air might be a bit fresh, especially first thing for an early start, then it can actually feel a little bit cold. So if that is the case, you need to make sure that you really focus on a thorough warm-up. Keep it on the dry land if need be so that you're staying extra warm. And once you've done your warm-up, layer up and keep your core nice and warm before you're getting in the water. And then once you start and the swim effort comes through, you'll probably forget about feeling a little bit chilly. You'll need to consider what to wear. And for this, you need to know the rules. And basically, if it's a non-wetsuit swim, you aren't allowed to have anything on you that's gonna aid your buoyancy. Hence my earlier point. You're also not allowed any fabric that goes beneath your elbows or below your knees. So if you're someone who races in calf guards of some sort, you're gonna have to factor that in that you can't swim in them. And if you do like to have something on your calves for the bike or the run, or maybe even aero sleeves on your arms, you'll have to think about putting them on in transition and it might be something worth practicing. And then you've got the really straightforward option of just wearing your tri-suit at no extra cost, basically whatever you're going to race in. But you do have the added option of putting on a swim skin over the top of your tri-suit, which gives you those hydrodynamic benefits. And within that, you've got the option of a sleeveless or a sleeve. And then you also need to think about how you want to wear your tri-suit under that. If your tri-suit has got sleeves, you might just consider wearing a swim skin like this that you literally put over the top. You can also roll your tri-suit down and then wear it under the swim skin so your shoulders are free. But you have to then remember you're gonna tackle that wet tri-suit trying to get it on in transition. And if you watch the pros, they do a bit of a variation. So it's definitely one that you need to figure out for yourself. Obviously, I want to give you the confidence about swimming in the open water, but I can't sugarcoat the fact that there might sometimes be the odd jellyfish around. But on the whole, most of them aren't going to sting you and they're just going to touch you and brush off. And things that you do feel touching you or brushing you are just going to be that. Might well be a bit of seaweed or just some very innocent sea life that is just going to be a sensation. And you have to just let that pass by and imagine of how many swimmers there are, the chances of anything getting you is going to be very slim. And my advice would be make sure that you are working hard enough, concentrating on sighting in the right direction, going hard in a straight line, and then you won't really even notice things. That's definitely been my tactic in the past, and I've finished races and people have told me, oh my God, did you see those massive jellyfish? And I've not seen them at all, so that's my tactic. In part, it's a psychological benefit, but there are also physical benefits. And if you're weighing up whether to invest in a swim skin or just go with your tri-suit, then we've recently done a comparison video on GTN, which I'd suggest checking out. But if you are swimming somewhere where the water's on the cusp and it suddenly gets made into a last minute non-wetsuit swim, you really will not be alone by swimming just in your tri-suit.
In fact, triathlon suits have advanced significantly over the years and slip through the water incredibly well on their own.
Well, this varies so much from swimmer to swimmer. If we take a look at the pros, then on the whole, a non-wetsuit swim is going to benefit the most efficient swimmers, the stronger swimmers, because their stroke is just that much more fine-tuned and doesn't rely on that buoyancy from the wetsuit. You'll also notice that smaller packs form in the pro field and everyone gets broken up a little bit more easily. But when it comes to yourself, then yes, the swim is going to take longer. However good a swimmer you are, you're going to be out there for a little bit longer if it's a non-wetsuit swim. So you want to factor that in and make sure you pace yourself accordingly. And it might start to feel a little bit harder. Just remember that you're not going to be the only person wishing you had your wetsuit on. Everyone is in the same boat. However, if you did have your wetsuit on, I think you'd be cursing just how hot you would be. Well, yes, there are some positives. I mean, first up, you're not going to overheat, which is a pretty big one. I must admit, I have done a couple of races when the water temperature's been on the cusp and it stayed as wetsuit legal and I've been so hot in my wetsuit. And you're probably thinking, why didn't I take it off? Well, because of all the bonuses that everyone else would be getting as well. So I just stuck with it. You've also got that added freedom around your shoulders. It's something that I really notice when it comes to longer distance swims, of just not having that resistance of a wetsuit. Plus, you're gonna be quicker in transition. If you're just in your tri-suit, you'll be super quick. If you're wearing a swim skin, it's still gonna be a lot quicker to get off than a wetsuit. And you don't need to splash out on a really expensive racing wetsuit. So there you go. There's something to smile about if you do have a non-wetsuit open water swim coming up. Well, a big thanks to my friend for being so honest on all of her fears. And I'm sure you guys will relate to some of those, but hopefully this has helped you. Good luck for your next race.